Hello friends, welcome to the another lecture of the pin diagram of 8086 microprocessor. Today we are going to cover the remaining pins. This is the fifth part of this session. Till now we cover the pins from pin number 1 to 20, 21, 22, 23, 40, 39, 38, 37, 36, 35, 34 and 33. So all these pins are the general pins which will work in both the cases. Now here we are going to see the functionality of some specific pins. That means the pins which will work in the minimum mode as well as the pins which will work in the maximum mode. So all these pins from pin number 31 to pin number 24. Pin number 31 to pin number 24 are having two functionalities. One is outside the pin and another is in the bracket. So the pin, description, the pins which are in the bracket are working in case of minimum mode, while the pins which are outside it are working in the case of the maximum mode. Okay, so this minimum mode and maximum mode pins are remaining here, out of which the very first pin is from pin number 24. This pin number 24 is your INTA pin, that is the interrupt acknowledgement. This is the interrupt acknowledgement pin. It means whenever a interrupt comes on this interrupt request pin, and if the system is unable to execute that particular interrupt right after this request, system will send an interrupt acknowledgement to that particular interrupt, which shows that system needs some time to accumulate the capacity of all the resources, whether with the help of the free or accumulated or the capacity of a resource which are right now available, are able to execute that particular interrupt or not. And if not, then system will need to deprioritize some already executing tasks and collect the resource capability. So for all these things, system will need some time, and for that particular time, system will send an acknowledgement to that particular interrupt that we need some time, let us wait for some time. And just after accumulating all these resources and all this calculation, system will start working on that. So this is the function of this interrupt acknowledgement pin. Next is the ALE, that is the pin in the bracket is your ALE. ALE is your address latch enable pin. This pin is used to bifurcate the data of the address and data that are available on the pin number AD0 to AD15. So whenever 0 on this pin, it shows the data, it represents whatever comes on this AD0 to AD15 is data. And whenever the system will say, will see that key, there is some value on the pin AD0 to AD15, but if ALE is 1, then system will treat that particular data as a address for the next execution. Now the next is the DEN pin, the pin number 26, which is DEN. This pin number 26 is used for data enable pin. It works when the system is at logic low, kyunki iske par laga hai bar. So this DEN means data enable pin. Whenever the pin is set as 0, then system will treat that particular data and take it into the consideration for calculation of any value or any execution. Even if the ALE is 0, it means system will identify that this is the data on the AD0 to AD15 pin, but system will not using that data for any further calculation until and unless if the status of this DEN pin will be 1. Now the next is the pin number 27. Pin number 27 shows the DT oblique R. It means data transmit and data receive. So this data transmit and data receive means ki works in case of the minimum mode whenever a system is requiring some access from the microprocessor, that is like a DMA. So in that case system, the external resource or a controller will request from the processor that we are having some data to execute. We need some resource for that. So in that case, system will use this pin, that is DT/R, in case of minimum mode only. Whenever the system will see the bit 0 on this, it means system is receiving the data in case of minimum mode. And if it is 1, then system will accept the data, will send the data as a transmitter in case of minimum mode. Again, the pin number 28, which shows the M/IO, that is memory and input output ports. So IO ke upar laga hai bar, it means it is working when system is having bit 0 and this is working. This functionality will work in case the pin is having a status 1. It means ki whenever system is getting the information that this pin is set as 1, it means system need to use or extract the data from the memory. But if the status of this pin is 0, it means system need to collect the data from the input output devices, that is IO. Again, on this upper side of this pin is the WR. WR means write, when system would like to write something. So this pin is used, and there are two more pins in case of the minimum mode. One is the hold and another is hold hey, that is hold acknowledgement. So this hold and this hold acknowledgement means system will consider the hold as well as the hold acknowledgement status. Hold means if a system is working in the minimum mode and finds some data which is not to be executed at just right moment, at the moment whenever the data appears, then system will set the status of this hold pin as 1. It means in case of minimum mode, the device which is connected with your device is able to know that we need to hold for some time, and hold acknowledgement means system is now going to execute this data just from the next clock cycle. So this will set the status of this hold A to the acknowledgement. It means it is the hold acknowledgement. Now for the remaining pins, we are having a next